We don't know. We won't know
then
until
Tommy.
Well, I have the name on something. You'll hold him? No? Do you want to hold him? We won't know if Tommy's a boy or a girl until he's about this big. So you know what that means? We have to cross our fingers and hope we don't have to change Tommy's name to Tammy one day. Do you guys want to see him walk for a second again?
Yeah!
He can be quick, but most of the time he just moseys on along. He's just gonna hang out for me.
Whoa.
He's gonna hang out. Stay back here. Now he's just gonna sit there. Me, cutie pie. Does anyone know what the largest tortoise species is?
Humpback turtle.
That's a turtle. What's the largest tortoise? Do you guys want to know? The Galapagos tortoise. Galapagos tortoise is the largest species. They get massive. They get several hundred pounds.
Wait, can you see how big is the couch?
Yeah. They're probably pretty close to it. They're huge, massive tortoises.
Okay, this big?
Massive.
This big?
As big as that counter?
But they get big. They get
tall.
A big
on a house.
Not as big as a house.
This
no.
big.
Should we see our next animal?
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah.
Get up again.
No, we're not gonna get up, guys. Sit down. Remember, if you don't like it, you just say no, thank you.
Yeah, no, sure.
And we'll just say I don't. No, thank you. Just she won't bring it by you, okay?
Thank you.
Yep, you can do that. Jazz the Chalupa.
Chalupa.
He's not a Chalupa. What is he?
A chinchilla.
Chinchillas are the world's softest animal. Do you guys know that?
Oh, I knew that.
You will never feel an animal softer than a chinchilla. Do you guys know why they're so soft?
Why?
Do you know why?
Their fur.
Their fur? Yeah, what about their fur?
They're so soft.
It's super thick. What else were you going to say? Very good. Good job. So who here has really thick hair? Okay. This is kind of hard to understand, so you gotta listen close. Do you know the hair on our heads comes out of a little tiny hole?
Yeah.
That little tiny hole is called a follicle. Now, if you have thick hair, you have about 4 hairs that come out of each follicle. If you have thin hair, you have about 2 hairs that come out of each follicle.
Maybe 1.
Guess how many hairs come out of each chinchilla follicle? No.
100.
No.
100.
Not 100. 60 to 70. That gives them the world's softest fur. So, how long does it take you guys with thick hair to dry your hair after a shower?
An hour.
Takes a long time. How long do you think it takes them?
A minute.
Like half of a day.
Trick question. If a chinchilla gets wet, they die. Chinchillas cannot get wet. So
what if it's raining?
They take a bath in dust. All the dust I got out of Macy and Miley's bedroom. Dead season. But there is a volcanic ash in here that's ground up like a dust. And that is how a chinchilla takes a bath. So I'm going to let you guys pet him. And then we're going to watch him take a bath. What do you guys think? You want to do that?
Yeah.
All right. You want to feel him? So, do you guys see his whiskers moving all over the place?
Yeah.
Those are like his glasses. They don't make glasses for chinchillas. How rude. You want to pet him? So he uses his whiskers to help him feel what's around him. Don't grab him. We can't grab him. See how I'm holding on to his tail? That is what's respectful to chinchillas. It's not very soft. He looks fat, doesn't he?
Yeah.
He's not fat. That's all fur. So chinchillas don't like to be grabbed around their body because it's kind of scary to them. They think
their ears are not soft.
So they like to have somewhere to sit. So I'm letting him sit on my hand.
And I'm holding on to his tail. Because that's what's respectful.
He just likes to hop.
Does he?
If I let go of his tail, your birthday party's over. You don't know why?
Because he hops everywhere.
He hops everywhere. When he's standing still, he can jump over 4 foot high. And when he's running, he can jump over 5 foot high. So I don't let him go because I did at a birthday party once. And it took us 45 minutes to catch him. And you want to see the other animals I brought,
yeah.
Right? Yeah. What do you guys think?
And then you didn't get to pet any other animals?
We didn't get to see other animals because I had to catch him. Oh, what do you think? What do you think? Now, he is not a normal color chinchilla. Normally, chinchillas are a dark gray, but he is a really pretty unique color. Do you guys want to know where chinchillas come from? The Andes Mountains. They come from an environment that's cool because they do not like it hot. Not at all. Alright, did you pet him?
Yeah.
You pet him? Alright, are you ready for his bath?
Yeah.
Suffocation.
I got to stay there. Now, he does not get a bath every day. He gets a bath about twice a week. If we stay back, everyone will be able to see. Chinchillas are just like humans. They have to have someone to teach them how to take a bath. They don't know how to take a bath on their own. They have to have their mama teach them. Now, because they cannot get wet, they really don't drink much water. Most of the water they get from the plants and the shrubs that they're eating. They really don't drink much water at all. Now, the reason why we pet him before he gets his bath is because if we pet him now, we are going to be covered in dust. We don't want that dust all over.
And your dust all over.
I have dust and fur all over me. It happens every time. We are super duper thankful to still have chinchillas. Do you guys want to know why? They were almost extinct.
No, I'm saying there.
Do you guys know what extinct means?
Yeah. Yes. You can't see them anymore.
Zero left. And they were almost extinct because people were taking them out of the wild and making coats and jackets and hats out of them. Now, thankfully, someone said no more taking them from the wild. You can only take the ones that are born in the United States. So we have to let them have babies in the wild, but you can't touch them. So thankfully, someone said that they couldn't do that anymore. And they were only taking ones that were born specifically to become. So, it's sad, but we're thankful that he did that because otherwise they'd be extinct and that wouldn't be good, would it? No. Are you done bathing? Guys, don't look at him. He's in the bath. Are we ready for our next animal?
Yeah.
Let's put Jazz in his bed.
It's okay.
There has to be a skunk. Skunk.
Don't be a skunk.
Skunk.
Please be a skunk. How do you know that there's a skunk? Because it's new.
A dead puppy.
What? You just have everybody was all looking at you. You're taking pictures. You're a photographer.
Maybe.
Don't touch it.
That beautiful bean. It's a brown bean. No, it's not poop, it's a brown bean.
Then you go and eat it. You're so smart.
Well, I don't like beans.
I actually do not.
Yes, it is a skunk.
Skunk!
The actual skunk.
Is flower. You guys still like flower? What is flower?
A skunk.
We also nickname our skunk a fart squirrel. So, who here has a cat again?
Hair.
Cats can kind of be grumpy sometimes, right?
My cat always is.
Okay, yeah. Cats are kind of grumpy animals, right? I think skunks are better pets than cats.
Okay, Mom, get us a skunk.
But here's the downside to that. You can't have a skunk as a pet in Illinois, which is a really big bummer because I really think they're a better pet than a cat is. Cats don't always want to play with you, right? Nope. If you want to play with your skunk, they want to play with you. If you want to cuddle, they want to cuddle with you. Flower's litter box dream, but I don't have to buy her kitty litter. She goes potty in her litter box on newspaper. I don't have to go to the pet store and buy her kitty food. You want to know what she eats? Chicken, turkey, hard-boiled eggs, scrambled eggs, raw eggs, cottage cheese. Sometimes she likes to snack on string cheese. She eats salads, and she eats a teeny tiny bit of fruit. And bugs. She doesn't get bugs, too. She's really easy to feed because she eats a ton of the same things that we eat. And she is a sweetie pie. You want to pet her? You want to hold her? You have a crushed applesauce? I'll sit her in your lap.
I don't.
No, that's okay.
No, thank you.
So, the bad thing about skunks is they are baddies.
Okay.
Here, open your leg up a little bit more. Let her fall down in there. Open your legs a little bit more. There you go. Keep pulling it out. Keep pulling it out. Let her sit down in there. There you go.
Okay. Better not see.
Oh, she doesn't see. Don't worry. So, if you crisscross your legs a little bit more and let her sit down in there and rub her. Do you see how I'm giving her a place to sit down in there?
Yeah.
Can you open?
Yeah,
open.
And if you open. Don't.
There you go. There. So, Flower has her fart removed. She can't stink at all. So
yeah, okay, then I'll try.
No, that was my boots.
She wants her mom.
I'll try.
Hi, honey. But you've got to go see our birthday girl.
I can't.
That's okay. Try this.
I'll do
again.
It now.
All right, rubber. Rubber. Give her good rubs. Good job.
She was talking to me.
So I will say she is pretty freaked out by hardwood floors. She does not like hardwood floors. So the chance that she'll run off this rug, we don't like hardwood floors, do we? Let's see what else. She is the most common color skunk, isn't she?
Yes.
This is the skunk that we see around here in Illinois.
Let's dye her pink.
Huh?
Let's dye her pink.
Let's dye her pink. No, we can't dye her pink. There are other colors of skunks, though. There is even a polka-dotted skunk. There's a tan-colored skunk, but she's the most common color. She was actually born in Chatham. You guys know where Chatham is? It's not far from here. She wasn't born in the wild, though. She was born to someone that raised her. Raised her mom and raised her dad and raised her brothers and sisters. Are you hiding?
No.